company can be taken over by somebody, even if it is some sort of organizational deficit inside a company, that will be because of the product value of the company, it will be taken over by somebody else and it will flourish. So if a company has these five qualities, that it is having perennial reliability and demand of service in the society, and number two, the company which has the sturdity of facts, and the company which is capable of re-stabilizing its own self within the, these things, and number fourth, the company which is well infrastructuralized and very much established over the period of time, and a company where even the organizational deficit can result in the takeover by a capable tool or a capable hand which can remodelize or restructuralize the company. Such companies are very great in number. And the final thing what I want to say here is, even though we are spiritual in nature, we must bother about economy. Because economic depression that will make the persons to be deeply immersed in mundane and filthy factors like food. Each and everybody will be worrying about those things. Somebody will be worrying about the petrol to their belly, and somebody will be for their Rolls Royce, somebody for Maruti 700, somebody for their flight. So it is just a demand or a necessity. So if the society is very much haunted or overruled by these type of deficient factors, then spiritual knowledge will not get into them. And also, even if you advise something spiritually, and all things will be ruled out. A country where there is imbalanced economy, where somebody flourish, where somebody perish, this type of imbalanced economy that will create lot of ethical and moral imbalances and abnormity. If ethics and morale does not rule, spiritualism cannot find any rule, except some people like who are doing rituals for stock exchange development and share value increase, those who are organizing pujas for share prediction and other thing, those who are special prediction tools like astrologers and palmists, those who are specialists in share predictions. Unless these people are very much inclined towards benefiting such communities, other rest of the people in the real spiritual kingdom, they are known as pseudo spiritual kingdom, the real spiritual kingdom will be very much affected because of this imbalance. So apart from I was very much thinking about the global stock exchange. But then I thought about the NSE and this BSE, etc. So while we were thinking about various other things, then I have been put now in a position to think about this building and its development. So instead of very much widening our thought and proposal, instead of thinking about the global economy or global market or Bombay Stock Exchange and National Exchange, now we have to finally concentrate more upon the Stock Exchange of Hyderabad. And upon
regional.
Yes. It is told in the Shastras, there are some 10 commandments which I want to say in some other lecture. One commandment I can say now. One is, where you are going to be benefited. You are a beneficiary, somebody is a benefactor. You are a beneficiary receiving it, somebody is going to be benefactor. So you have to take care. You are a beneficiary, you are taking care of yourself. At least twice or thrice you have to take care of your benefactor. You are going to school, that is a benefactor of knowledge to you. You are going to your office, that is a benefactor in the form of salary, interest or profit to you. So it is a stock exchange. It is your benefactor. It is your visible temple of fortune. It is the abode of your work and its rate of success. So if it is not being taken care, then certainly it is a very great curse on us. And whatever we do, the process of personality development and personal beautification, that results in no benefit, I think. So that may be not immediately possible, even though we are interested. It has been told, and also we can infer that lot of hindering forces are there. It is a collective phenomenon. Whenever we are coming to an organization, there are group of people, and group of people, they come inside a proper area. It does not mean that they are all like-minded. As 100 people are traveling in the same bus, it does not mean that 100 people will do the same work. But in an organization, bus is not an organization, it is transportation. You will get down at your stop and you will do your own work. It does not mean that you have traveled in that bus, so everybody do the same work. It is not that, because bus is not an organization. But this is an organization in which, in all the areas, we must be uniform and unanimous. And in the other areas, whereas our personal thing is there, liking music, eating food, wearing, everything that is personal. And whenever we are doing as a constitution, then certainly we all must be like-minded, and we must try to be like-minded, and ego clashes must be avoided, and total, I have done it, you have done it, it is known as ego. we have to do it. Anyhow, if we are doing the clash like this, then it is a total loss to both of us. So whenever it is coming to such point, then mutual integrity and understanding, forgivingness, adapting things, reasonable adjustment, not intolerable adjustment. Intolerable adjustment is dangerous to the organization, a reasonable adjustment. So it does not only require the policies of stock management and start marketing our business. It also requires the proper ways of relation management, personality development, how to construct relation between like-minded people, how to create awareness about the economy and other things. So apart from here stock, it is no doubt we are going to do only stock, but it requires also extracurricular skills like intuitive skills. There are three types of skills. I have already told anticipatory inflation. Some problems are going to come. It is predicted by our tabulation study over decades. It is known as chronological chart. That is known as anticipatory. Predictive means while you are looking through the various economical and political factors, if you have experience, you can predict. Intuitive is God-given thing. If a problem is come, we cannot solve the problem. At least we can do self-escapism by not investing those things. At least selling those things through short selling or something else, so that we will not be avoided. We will not be totally getting into that loss. So, preventing from loss, minimizing loss, getting profit, boosting profit, four things are four dimensions of profit. Just profit is not profit. Boosting profit is also profit. Getting something is also profit. Not getting loss is also profit. If you want to get loss, minimization of that loss is also a profit. So, intuitive, predictive and anticipatory systems are to be there. We can get the predictive systems from knowledgeable persons, valuable economists. You can get the anticipatory systems by tabulation and charts of your own stock exchange review and preview. You can get intuitive things only by the guidance of spiritual authorities. I wish you to get that intuitive thing, irrespective of the God or the God that you worship. You must get the consciousness level awakened by the intuitive thing of which you must guide others to minimize their loss. Also, you can take your life in a very peaceful way without much of anxiety and perplexity. So, I wish and bless that it shall be renovated soon, and at least the fans are to be reactivated for my comfort. The lips are becoming dry. So at least a minimum development of reactivation of the inbuilt systems, which will, there will be always between people. When there is a conflict between people, you know that if there is a place, whether stock exchange is going to rise or fall, this area is going to be appreciated, because it is an appreciable value irrespective. For immediate returns or immediate liquidation of funds, it may not be applicable, but at any time real estate is a value of appreciation. So this thing is a very valuable asset. It's a very big building. To get to procure such a building and to organize this thing is not a very easy thing. If you start now, already it has been a God-given gift for all of us. GGG, God-given gift for all of us. So it is our duty to take care of its health and restoration of its beauty, and also organizational beauty, structural beauty, organizational beauty and success beauty. These three of the things must be assured by all of you. I am wish and bless and all members of the society, both like-minded and unlike-minded, to unite. Let the disputes be resolved, and let me be invited once more again in a very happy and prosperous stock exchange. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.